Prolonged periods of drought and erratic rainfall have become more frequent due to massive deforestation in Karamoja region. In Karamoja, charcoal business had taken over as a means of livelihood, leading to massive cutting down of trees from protected forest reserves in the area. The locals say even their shrines have been cut for charcoal.
I sell now, buy for them beans, buy for them posho.
If they have no food to eat, they have to burn charcoal to get some money to buy food.
Here we are at the foot of the mountain, and at the moment I'm looking at a lot of smoke coming from different locations because people are burning charcoal.
Zakari, a resident of Loputuk village, flashes back to the past where certain species were not meant to be cut. He says hunger has contributed to the growing charcoal burning. This has affected the ecosystem and hence the livelihood of the community.
That people want to burn charcoal and take and sell to town because of the hunger that they are facing. People have resorted even cutting trees that even elders were telling them not to cut.
With Uganda losing hundreds of hectares of forest every year to population pressure, illegal logging and charcoal burning, community involvement is key.
Targeting the people who are staying in the forest, we are targeting those ones who are at the mountain. Again, the categories of these people, we have the grazers, we have the charcoal burners, we have those who cut trees for coals, for firewood, for charcoal, and those who are doing some small mining, those who are doing agriculture, those who are hunting. All this group, we want them to be in this group so that they can minimize on their activities in the forest.
Farmers have also been trained on tree planting and how to maintain the gardens. Over 20 hectares of land have been affected by the community for planting, and 200 farmers will benefit from this program.
Districts, we are doing a target of 250,000 seedlings. Then the same apply to Nakabiribirit also. Now the species that we are doing here are seven in numbers. We have the first one, we have the Terminalia brunei, we have the Acacia polycanta, we have the Acacia totalis, we have the Kaya antotega, we have the Macamia, then the last one we have Acacia senegal. It is the one that is our main intention because for them they can perform in this area.
Opening the gardens, they are participating also in the measuring. We want them to take a lead in putting the pits for these trees. And we are advising them to work in groups.
Karatunga, a local NGO, has embarked on the plantation of over 500,000 indigenous tree species in the districts of Moroto and Nakapiripiriti to help preserve the protected areas from the growing pressure of tree cutting for charcoal burning and construction. This comes shortly after the presidential directive on charcoal and bush burning. Agnes Najuma for the news.